Hello all, welcome to the video on awake brain surgery inside the operating room. My previous video was preparation of the patient before entering the OT, and in this particular video I will be covering the anesthesia aspects patient should know after entering the operating room. The surgeries like brain tumors which are located in the functional areas are done under awake state, and also certain epilepsy surgeries where the epileptic foci is located near the functional areas like motor and speech area are also done under awake state. And certain procedures like deep brain stimulation which are done for diseases like Parkinson's disease, which is having a fine tremor in the patient, are also done under awake state. Apart from saving the functional areas and increasing the extent of resection, studies are showing that awake craniotomies have a shorter hospital stay and less incidence of postoperative infections. In the pre-anesthesia checkup, the most important aspect is patient selection. The tumors which are large in size and very deeply located are a bad choice for awake craniotomy. And also patients who have a subnormal mental state and very apprehensive are also a bad choice for awake brain surgeries. Apart from this, there are certain contraindications like patient's refusal, having a bad cough in the patient which would affect the surgery, and also language barriers and bad snoring, also called as obstructive sleep apnea. So these are some of the relative contraindications for the procedure. Certain medications like antihypertensives, which are used to control the blood pressure, and sugar medications like antidiabetics, and drugs which are used to decrease the fits, and drugs which are used to decrease the pressure inside the brain, need to be continued on the day of the surgery based on the advice of your doctor. After entering the OT, anesthetist's main job is to keep the patient comfortable. For that, they would be using sponges or pillows on the operating table, and they try to keep the operating room temperature warm at a particular temperature like 22 to 23 degrees centigrade, and they will avoid multiple staff entering the operating room, which would increase the noise and apprehension in the patient. There are different types of anesthesia techniques, but broadly they are classified as asleep-awake techniques and awake-throughout techniques. Asleep-awake technique is like they sedate the patient in the initial part of the surgery, and we wake up the patient when we actually test the functional cortex, that is called as mapping procedures. And in awake-throughout techniques, we keep the patient awake throughout the procedure with mild sedation, but in both the techniques, the patients would be comfortable, pain-free, and they will not have any kind of discomfort. You would have seen in some of the videos patients playing guitar during awake craniotomies. So why we actually do that is, if a person is depending for his livelihood on some skill like playing a guitar, so during the surgery we have to make sure that the person's skill is retained. So that is the reason we make sure they play during the procedure. So you need to know how the OT will be oriented during the awake brain surgery. On the head side, you would be seeing the chief surgeon and assistant surgeon operating on you. And on one side, the anesthetist and neurophysiologist will be sitting, and they will be doing the assessment, motor mapping and speech mapping. On the other side, there will be the scrub nurse and anesthesia technician. And certain instruments you'll be seeing inside the OT, like operating microscopes, neuronavigation systems, and infusion pumps. Certain medications what anesthetists prescribe or give inside the OT are painkillers to decrease your pain and keep you comfortable, and drugs which will decrease the vomiting sensations, and antibiotics to decrease the infection risk on the surgical side. So the anesthetic agents commonly used worldwide are mainly two. One is dexmedetomidine and propofol, which cause sedation in the patients. And to relieve the pain, some centers use fentanyl, and some centers in the UK and USA use remifentanil. So the most important step in awake craniotomy is blocking the nerves which supply the skin over the head or scalp. This is called as a scalp block. Since the brain doesn't have pain receptors and the bone covering the brain also doesn't have pain, if we make sure that the skin over the head is anesthetized by a good scalp block, the patient will not have any kind of pain during the procedure. I thought of covering cortical mapping for motor and speech in this video, but it is increasing the duration, which I do not want. So I will be doing that in a separate video. So what problems you can face? Based on my experience, what I saw is the incidence of seizures is quite common, but you don't have to worry about that. So during the procedure, if patient is getting a seizure, ice cold saline is administered on the brain and seizure is immediately controlled. And during the surgery, patient will be kept very comfortable, and once the surgery is over, then the patient is again resedated by using the same drugs, dexmedetomidine or propofol, which were initially used for sedation of the patient. And postoperatively, the patients are kept in a neurosurgical ICU or a postoperative neuro ward, where their blood pressure, heart rate, and oxygen levels will be measured for 4 to 6 hours, and then they will be shifted to ward. And in some countries like Canada, they are actually discharging on the same day, which are called as daycare neurosurgeries. So that is also seen. So in my next video, I will be covering the motor mapping and speech mapping of the brain, intraoperative MRI in brain surgery, and neuronavigation usage in brain surgeries, and ultrasound in brain surgeries. Thank you very much for following the video till now, and please post your comments, and please subscribe to the channel and click on the bell button. If you want me to make videos on specific aspects, please do comment. Thank you very much.